Just down below the stairs here, there's a mask wall that shows masks open like that. So when you take your pictures down there, you know the kind of masks that they're referring to. The regalia we're wearing is meant for winter ceremonies on the northern northwest coast. So it's a little warm today. It's wool and leather and fur. This next song we're going to do is part of the ceremony of raising any totem pole. Traditionally, they would all be done by hand with ropes, and people would pull them up, but, you know, modern days, we have cranes to do certain poles. But part of the ceremony is a carver's song. And this is the carver's last responsibility before the poles are officially handed over to their owner. And so in this song, you'll see my father's going to dance. A goal in his life, he thought, someday I'd like to be able to carve 75 totem poles. This is 75 and 76. Well, I've watched him do this many times, and I'm very honored to sing for him today. You'll see in the dance that he looks for the log, and he carves the pole, and then celebrates its completion. This is the carver's song.
Thank you.
events we're going to do. And I'd like to call up and ask if the people who made this event possible today from Disney would please come up and join us along this line, along with our dancers. And I see somebody in a button blank out in the crowd. If you'd like to come and dance too, please. This is Jen Schoolcraft. She's from our village at home. Thanks for coming, Jen. So, this is called Happy Dance. So, the men that are lined up down the line are going to be pulling in fishnets, and the ladies are going to be picking berries, and this is a song we do at the end of the season when we celebrate the year's harvest and we get ready for the winter. It's winter now, but you never know it. This is our last song, and then we'll have a parting word for you all, but thank you very much for being here and helping us celebrate today. Our people are divided up into four matrilineal clans, and we've helped some of these folks learn how to dance, and they'll be doing one of the four clan dances. The crests are Eagle, Raven, Wolf, and Killer Whale. Oh, and there's a special one. I don't know if anyone will do it, but you'll notice it when you see it.
They did really well, didn't they?
They did.
I have a little surprise for my father, and this is from the mayor of our village, who couldn't be here today, but wanted us to read this for him. Madam Mayor Audrey Hudson was not able to attend today, so she requested I speak on her behalf at this ceremony to unveil these two totem poles that have been created and carved by David Albert Boxley and his son. Metlakatlinian community, which is located on Annette Islands Reserve in Alaska, is home to the Tsimshian people. Holds great pride in knowing that our culture and art is being brought across the country for people from around the world to enjoy at Disney World. Mr. David Albert Boxley's roots in Metlakatla are very deep. He is a teacher, culture bearer, and role model for all Tsimshian people. His totem poles and other fine carvings can be found all over the world. His impressive career has lasted more than 3 decades. Mr. Boxley is also the father of 2 men who are impressive artists in their own right. Zach Boxley is a Bentwood box and drum maker. David Robert, she said something very nice about me and I'm too humble to read it. Today is a special day. Today marks an important milestone in Mr. Boxley's career. This is the 75th totem pole and 76th that Mr. Boxley has carved out of cedar. Our community is beaming with pride knowing that Tsimshian legends depicted in these magnificent sculptures are representing our people. Both poles demonstrate world-class craftsmanship. On behalf of the Metlakatlinian community, council, executives, and membership, I congratulate the Boxleys for this monumental achievement. The Tsimshian of Metlakatla, Alaska are very proud of your hard work, your leadership, and for always being strong ambassadors for Metlakatla. Ams upsum. Good job, Mayor Audrey Hudson.
What a special morning this has been already. I'd like to just say thank you so much to the Gidhwan troop. What a beautiful performance and moving as well. And so I hope you all will join me in congratulating this group for such a spectacular. And Walt Disney World, we are humbled and honored to receive these wonderful gifts from your tribe. They will be a very meaningful addition to the Canada Pavilion and to Epcot and to Walt Disney World. So in closing, thank you all for joining us today for this momentous occasion. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day exploring the wonder here at Epcot and exploring the Epcot International Festival of the Arts. Thank you all.
Stand with us and take a picture. Now you can take pictures.
Here we go, guys.
If you're here tomorrow, please come and see us. We have a much longer performance, a lot more masks. In fact, you get to see all these good-looking women dance tomorrow. Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. 11:30, first performance.